It's easy to discover who he is. Just Google him, please, as often as possible. He's a writer, actor, director, and alumnus of the New York Neo-Futurists. He spends his spare time live tweeting award shows and The Real Housewives of Atlanta. He once described himself as an actor of some renown to Jordana Williams and is still not embarrassed by it because he was only repeating what someone else said to him. This is Kevin R. Free!
You can keep it going. No, okay. What if I told you that I've always known that I am extraordinary? What if I told you that I've lived through tragedies and can give you advice about your own issues? What if I told you that I know you and know that you know me, even if you don't think you know me? Well, I am telling you all of that. And more. I have tried many things. I've been insecure, but now I know where I belong. Tonight, I am taking a page out of Sarah Palin's playbook, and I say, I am confident, and therefore, I am qualified to serve as Oprah. Okay, maybe not Oprah. I recognize that black people only get one supremely powerful, rich, influential person to create culture for the rest of the world per generation. And in my generation, we've got her. Okay, and Barack Obama. So the field is saturated, all right? I will accept just famous. Not Vivica A. Fox or Michael Vick famous. No, like Eddie Murphy, Will Smith famous, only gay. Openly. My New Year's resolution this year, as it is every year, was to be famous. But this time is different. I won't focus on the stuff I've been focusing on since I was a child. Food, sex, music, theater, musical theater, education. All of that stuff I thought was going to make me famous was only making me popular. So high school. Fame isn't about popularity, people. Fame is about focus, and I am ready to focus on me. I will wear fame like a puffy, billowy, gauzy shirt. I will make fame my forever boyfriend. Like most famous people, I am a one-trick pony, and my trick is that I am famous. I am a one-man reality series. I always knew I'd make it. I once sent my headshot to Rosie O'Donnell because she was having a look-alike show. I told her in my letter that I was always mistaken for Rosie O'Donnell on the street. It wasn't true, but it made her show my picture on her show. That was gonna be my big break. It wasn't. Then I went to a taping of her show. I raised my hand during a commercial break to remind Rosie of who I was, and she snubbed me, which is a story in itself, and that story isn't my big break either. But I will tell her that story when she finally sees me. I will not be invisible anymore, and Rosie will find me. Rosie, you find me. I am not hard to find. I'm right here. Look at me. Everyday people have been coming stars for years. And I, too, am about to answer the call. My iPhone will be on speaker, and I will hold it like a slice of pizza, and the whole world will hear my destiny talking to me. That is what the people want. Real people rising to the top, making all of us real. I am confident, and I am qualified to serve. Like Obama, right? Obama gave us real. He sent us emails at the same time we were all receiving emails from other people from whom we didn't want to hear. But he made us all famous because we voted for him. And if we are disappointed in him, we should be able to email and tweet him and YouTube comment and respond to the emails he still sends about why. We made him Black Jesus because he asked us to. And we get to say when it's time for him to suffer. If he doesn't answer prayers, then we get to burn a cross in his front yard. OMG, I want that. I want people to be so happy with me and then so mad at me, and then I want someone else to armchair quarterback it and call my detractors racists. And I want to call a press conference to address none of what they said, and instead let everyone know that I've released a book, or an album, or a podcast, or all my anger at my former lovers and business partners. I want to write a book that everyone owns and no one reads. Well, maybe I want people to read it. Enough that they'll quote from it. And that'll be easy, because the book will be a compilation of all my tweets. Why didn't I scan all my meal receipts and put them in an Excel document? Because I was busy tweeting. That is my job. I have bottomless credit because I am my job. I am my job. This is what I want. I am like so many other Americans. I am you. I'm Christine O'Donnell. I'm a witch. I want to put a spell on you. I want to mesmerize you with my life, with my made-up behind-the-scenes problems. I want you to sign the release form so we can show your face on my reality show. Even if you don't know me, you think... Even if you don't know me, you think someone around here will. And you can send an email to your list about being on a TV show with me. Because like every famous person, you won't know me till you know me, and then you'll think you know me. I am stealthy like Sarah Palin. I will sneak in and become a media darling. I'll be reviled by you, but loved by people you never want to meet. I am going to ignore the world's real problems by being so blinded by my ambition that you can't help but be absorbed by my self-absorption. I deserve to be famous. I deserve a diamond-encrusted microphone. I am not an everyday person. I am extraordinary, like a really good-looking actor at his first audition. I am better, faster, funnier. I am embarrassingly smart. Remember how smart we thought Obama was by always maintaining a calm exterior during the campaign? Yeah, he's not going to be an angry black man because that's going to scare everybody away from voting for him. He's smart. He's calm. He's cool. Very cool. He smokes. He goes on talk shows. But he plays basketball, so we're sure that once he's in office, he'll get mad enough to put some right-wingers and Joe Lieberman in their proper places. We'll get our angry black man who knows his power in a room full of white people. That is a laugh, right? He needs to learn the definition of power. Okay. Well, I am not trying to win anyone over with poetry so that I can bore them with prose. No, honeys. I am your angry black man. I am telling you now, I will say what needs to be said, do what needs to be done to make myself famous to you. I will go off when somebody crosses me. I will roll my neck, raise my finger, tell you to Google me and do my resume, and then I will end the whole thing with a, who gon' check me, boo? Pick me. Make me famous. Do it. I am Sarah Palin. I am Barack Obama. I am Kim Zolciak. I have the confidence, therefore I am qualified to serve. Do not be tardy for my party. I am every motherfucking Tea Party candidate. Every boy, every girl, everyone who learned that. If you go to college or not, work hard or not, eat healthy or not, watch TV, celebrate Christmas or hate Christmas or love to hate Christians, who lives in the USA, drives donuts in the parking lots of Smokey Bones or other chained establishments in every suburb of every town and every state that we probably can't even find on a map, learned that you will get somewhere just by being yourself. That is who I am, and I deserve to be heard. I'm an individual in a world of collectives. The proverbial bagel on a plate of onion rolls. That was a gay reference. Seriously, I have to be famous. What would my life have been about otherwise? What if there is another gay black boy in the South with great hair, good looks, athlete's foot, a weight problem, Time Warner cable, and an affinity to country music and women's issues who has no role models to emulate? What about him? How will he know that it all gets worse before it gets better? What about me? I am not offering an alternative. I am not offering a new take on an old party, grand or otherwise. I offer conformity. Love me. Because I am more of the same old shit. I am my own delicious train wreck of a reality show, and I know it. I am Wendy Williams. I am you. No, scratch that. I am better than you. Because I define who I am based upon what you want. I am confident, and therefore I am qualified to serve you. I will realize the dream I've always had. And that dream has always had everything to do with you. Yes, You can make me famous. And once I'm there, I will be honest about using you to stay there until I die. Penniless and alone, when I'll finally gain some respect. Or pity.